lecture, we have discussed the various frictional resistance offered by the components. So, how to apply it? So, we have taken one layout of bed conveyor system as it consists of head pulley, which is connected to prime mover, tail pulley, endless belt, then carrying rod idler, the idler which supports belt as well as the material, then return rod idler which supports the belt, then belt tensioning device to maintain the tension in belt, and snug pulleys to change the direction of belt and to increase the lap angle. So now, because of introduction of these components, there are various frictional resistances. So how to apply those formula? We will see. Now, as you can see in the figure, this is head pulley. So if it is rotating in anti-clockwise direction, then there will be tight side on upper side. So this will be F tight, then it will be F slack. And hence, so we will take next point. So at what point we should take point 1? So obviously this is belt cleaner device, we should take point 1 after belt cleaner. So this is belt cleaner device. We will take point 1 after belt cleaner device. Why it is so? If we take point 1 at this, then there is no component in between F slack and F one. So tension will be same. So we will take point 1 after belt cleaner device. So what will happen? The tension of frictional resistance at point 1 will be F one is equal to F slack plus frictional resistance offered due to belt cleaning device, like here at point 1, F1 will be equal to F slack plus FCL, frictional resistance due to cleaning device. It will be KCL into G into B. B is the width of belt in meter, KCL is the constant of belt, it will be given in your meter. Now, you will get frictional resistance at point 1 in terms of F slack, because at this
Yeah.
So it will be F9 will be equal to FA plus frictional resistance offered due to tail pulling, also plus the frictional resistance at the loading point. So it will be, this is mass flow rate in kg per second. This is VB, velocity of belt, and VR is the initial velocity of the material which is dropping from the hooper. So again, you will get F line in terms of F slack, because right now you don't know F slack. Next, at point 10, after point 9, you will take point 10 after carrying run height. So hence, F10 will be equal to F9 plus frictional resistance due to carrying run height. Now the formula, there will be addition of MM. Why? Because carrying run height supports mass of material as well as mass of belt. So hence MM in kg per meter and MB in kg per meter plus mass of one carrying run meter into number of carrying run meter upon L. So out of L1, L2, L3, you will take L3 because you have used carrying run meter for length L3. So you have used it, you will get the value of F10. Now at final point. At final point, what will happen? At final point, you will get F10. F10 will be equal to F10 plus frictional resistance offered due to head pull. Hence, you will get F10 in terms of F slack in Newton. Now, there is only one equation for two unknowns. So, you have to get another equation also. So you know that F type upon F slack is equal to e raised to mu theta, where mu s is the sliding coefficient of friction of head pulling. Theta is lag angle of head pulling in radian. Please remember that theta should be substituted in radian, then only your answer will be correct. So you will get F type in terms of F slack in equation 2. You will substitute this equation 2 in equation 1. You will get F type and F slack. After getting F type and F slack, you will get output power of belt conveyor system, F type minus F slack into velocity of belt upon 10 raised to 3 in kilowatt. So when you divide this output power with the help of mechanical efficiency, you will get input power. With the help of this, you will be able to select the proper amount of proper kilowatt motor to drive this whole system. Remember that frictional resistance due to all components should be considered while calculating F type and F slack. Then only you will get the correct value of output and ultimately correct value of input power to select the correct value of